In this video, we are going to create random-based entry signals. That might sound a little strange, but I promise that the results will be very interesting. So let's find out how to do that with MQL4. To get started, please click on the little icon here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file Simple Random Entry EA, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the onTick function and the two command lines here. We start by creating an integer variable with the modifier extern. That will allow the user to change the setting for this variable. And it will become interesting in the next video when we are going to create mass tests. Inside of the onTick function, we start by creating a signal. But we don't assign any value here because we are going to calculate that now. First, we start with this function. It is called mathsrand. And when you mark it and press F1, you will learn that it sets the starting point for generating a series of pseudo-random integer numbers. And to get a unique starting value, we use getTickCount as a parameter. Because getTickCount returns the number of milliseconds that have passed since we have started our system, and that number will always be unique, and therefore the combination of these two functions will always create a unique series of random numbers. To calculate our random number, we use mathrand. That's a different one. This one is with an additional S. And mathrand returns a pseudo-random integer within the range of 0 to 32,000. But with this expression, we will get two different values, either a 0 or a 1. And if our random number equals 0, we want to buy, so we assign the value buy to our signal. Otherwise, if the random number equals 1, we want to sell, so now we assign the value sell to our signal. And if our signal equals buy and the value for orders total is 0, that would mean that we have no open orders and we have a buy signal. And now we use order send to buy 10 microlot. Otherwise, if the signal equals sell and orders total is also 0, that would mean we have no open orders and a sell signal. And now we use order send to sell 10 microlot. Finally, we use the command function to output the text the current signal is, followed by the calculated signal. That's about it. If you don't understand what all the code here does, or if this was too fast for you, maybe you want to watch one of the other videos in this basic video series, or maybe even the premium course on our website might be interesting for you. For now, please click on the compile button. You shouldn't get any errors, and if that is the case, you can click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to Metatrader. And in Metatrader, you want to right-click into an empty chart, click on Template, Save Template, and save the template as tester.tpl. You can overwrite the old value, because tester.tpl is what we will see when we start the strategy test. And to do that, please click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R on your keyboard. Please pick the new file Simple Random Entry EA.ex4. Mark the visual mode here and start a test. Here we are, the Expert Advisor is running. Let's go to full speed. And you should get some results here. So basically the Expert Advisor is working, but it's a random entry, so let's stop that. Disable the visual mode, start a new test. In my case, we have made a net profit of $523.40. Now I will repeat the test. And because it's a random entry, we should now get a different result. We can already see that. This time the profit was only $83.54, but it is still a random-based entry, and it is a profit. Let's do another one. And this time we made $729 profit. So it is possible to use a random-based entry to generate profits. And in the next video we are going to do mass testing. But for now, you know how to create a random-based entry signal that can be automatically traded in your expert advisor. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL4 code.